Alrighty, everybody, we made the bracket. Oh yes, hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today we are in tournament contention mode. We are in the top 16 bracket. We are the number 15th seed right here. There's us against Matt of the Lavendar Town Liepards, the number 2 seed, of course, the other side of the bracket. Our number 1 seed is Jonas, and the number 16th seed, Brian. And then everyone else here, let's see, Robin and Carlos. Good to see Carlos made it in. Reggie and Jeremy, Kenneth and Christian P. Let's go to the inside, let's go this way. Dev, Florian, Calvin, of course we see Calvin, Laro, Paul and Jared. So, very, very tough competition here. It's a top 16 bracket. So I bring up the rules here because, let's see. Where is that rule here? Draft battle playoffs here. So playoff battles, it is not what you've been seeing recently. It is best of three. Number of participants determine spot in the playoff bracket. In the case of a tie, playoff position is already tied. So, you know, we kind of did that with Ross, right? We did the win and you're in thing last week. Playoff brackets will be determined by best of three games. So we have to beat, Matt twice to move on in this bracket. And we're the 15th seed going against number 2 seed. So you know what? We're the underdog. We're going to destroy some brackets. Okay? Where players are permitted to bring different team builds to each of these games. Each series will be given a week for completion, as always. So the biggest change is best of 3. So, again, as I said, in order to beat Matt, we have to beat him twice. In order to move on to the round of 8, do the same thing. We're either Dev or Florian to get to the top 4, and whoever survives this one, I'm gonna just choose a name, Calvin, let's say, because we know Calvin was top seed in our bracket. We beat Calvin to get to the finals, and we play whoever is on this side, which I'm just gonna assume Jonas, number 1 seed. Let's just assume that for now. It's finals to get the NPCL PDT championship of season 9. But our road isn't easy. Again, we're 15th seed, so let's see what Matt has. Matt has Aegislash, Hatterene, Sock, Hisuian Electro, Crobat, and Clawitzer, Darmanitan, Sandslash, Volbeat, Cleaver, and Miltank. So this is in no particular order, just because it's best of three. He can bring whatever he wants to bring, right? It doesn't matter what I say. You know, he has technically 3 shots, right? We both have 3 shots. We only have to land 2 of them to move on. So I'm not really predicting what he'll bring. I'm just kind of going to predict what I'm going to do. I have 2 configs for this. So we're going with our Firewater Grass Core, Dragon Steel Fairy Core combination. We're going back to basics. That worked really well against Ross last time, so hopefully it pays dividends here. Dual Screens, Misty Terrain, and Parting Shot here. Misty Terrain slash Thunder Wave, just because of statuses and whatnot. Same thing. The only change we made was the Meowscarada being banded instead of Scarf now. We don't have any Sucker Punches, which you can argue might be great against the Electrode and Crobat and Scarf the Manitan. But I think with this we'll be fine. We're running Celesteela. We're going more Spadef with Sassy Nature just because he has a lot. I think he has more special attacking mods, and I'll help us deal with Electrode. Heavy Snap Flinker, Earthquake, Leech Seed, Heavy Duty Boots, Cinderace, you already know the deal. Same thing with Assault Base, Regidrago, you already know the deal. And Morgrem, well, the only change being Misty Terrain and Thunder Wave. Let's see. Gastrodon running Sludge Wave to help us deal with Hatterene and Hisuian Electrode. And Rindu Berry is ran just because they both get Giga Drains and Chloroblast and Grass type coverage. What else has grass coverage on his team? Oops, I keep pressing the wrong tabs. Excuse me for the random clicking. Volbeat gets, well, nothing. Darmanitan gets Hidden Power Grass. So we're just running the Rindu Berry just to be extra safe. We're not really calculating anything. We're putting our bulk. That shouldn't be Serious Nature, by the way. Did I not press the bulk? I think this should be Bold, if I'm not mistaken. This should not be serious nature. I think this is supposed to be bold instead. My bad, folks. And then, yeah, we have our three moves. Sludge Wave helps us cover more. But yeah, this is Config 1. Config 2 is more of our Ascendant one. Again, I have serious nature. Why is that serious nature? I better make sure that's not serious nature before the match. But Celesteela. So this one's different. We're doing our full send Celesteela strat again just because it looks good. And hopefully it's our last chance to get a Celesteela sweep on 15 seed. So Autonomize, Heavy Slam, Earthquake, Acrobatics. Looks really good on his team. Flamethrower here. Acrobatics here. Acrobatics here. Acrobatics here. Acrobatics here. Acrobatics here. Earthquake. Acrobatics. 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 So Celesteela looks really good if we can get it going with the weakness policy, and I'm expecting to take a super effective hit. So hopefully this variability in Celesteela can throw him off a bit. Again, same Cinderace, same Regidrago. We're going back to Scarf Meowscarada, running Spikes instead just to force him to defog with Crobat and spin away. No, you don't get Rapid Spin. Spin away with Sandslash. So Spikes will come in handy as well. Same Gastrodon, though I am switching out Sludge Wave for Ice Beam this time around, just because I think Ice will hit a little bit harder, especially for Crobat. And it's same Morgrem, and I'm just showing that it's Thunder Wave slash Misty Terrain by switching it up with Thunder Wave here. Yeah, I really hope this is bold nature. I gotta remember to click that during the before the game, because serious nature, we're not going with neutral nature. That's not good. That will definitely affect the battle here. But yeah, this is our two configs heading into this matchup here. Honestly, his team looks beatable. His team looks beatable. He also took one loss on week 7. That's why he's number 2 and Jonas is number 1. So that was like kind of the battle for number 1 seed there. But yeah, like, this is a very balanced team, but also a very beatable team. So as long as we're on our A game and we can kind of control the pacing, stay calm, I can see us taking a good W here and move on to the round of 8. But of course, easier said than done. He is the number 2 seed for a reason. He has gone 6-1 for a reason. So we just one battle at a time. We get it's 2 out of 3, but the battle is ultimately won in 2 games. We need 2 wins, not 1 win. So stay calm and play our game, and we should put on a great show. But yeah, let's go to the bracket again. We are in the bracket, folks. We have a chance to win the championship, our first season in. So, you know, again, as I just said, one battle at a time, one battle at a time. Don't get ahead of yourself. One battle at a time. But that being said, I will see you all in the battle. I don't know how long it will be, considering that our battles against Kyle and Ross were about, what, 30 to 45 minutes of footage. I'm going to assume that these 2 out of 3 ones are going to be hour half of footage. So you guys get to enjoy 90 minutes of raw, uncut footage. So hopefully the audio captures and all that stuff. Yeah, until then, see y'all next time. Bye-bye.